Okay, good. It's recorded. Okay. Hi, everyone. Yeah, I cannot use my... Okay, I have to use this one. Hi, everyone. So you can see the screen right now, right? Okay, so you can see this is the current progress. Joy is killing me. Okay, this is the current progress of our oGV. From February until right now today, it's updated. So you can see on applicants, we have around 117 applicants. So you can see the top performing LC entity is Penang. Woo, Penang, good job. Then you can see as well is UPM, Sunway, and also TU. They are the high performing entity right now on applicants. However, if you check on the goal, it's much more like there's a huge gap on comparing the goal. Okay, yeah. So if this, okay, TU, we have to make sure that you have your goal for now, okay? Yeah. So, and you can see on applicants, it's also Penang, the high performing right now. And then Sunway, we have 7. TU, we have 8. And then the others are actually very, very little. Yeah. So this is a cross-check on what happening from February until March. And then I believe that with this current achievement, it's actually far behind. There's a huge gap according to the goal that we are actually setting. Am I right? Hello?
Yes.
Okay, I heard Penang. Yes. Okay, so with this, right, I just want to know like what happening and then what is the thing that we can move forward to make sure that we close up all the gap. Okay, so we can go to next slide. Okay, so before, later on, this is the current situation, the progress. So I will actually give everyone a slightly education about what is the thing that as an EP manager you have to know. Cool? Okay, so the first one is actually what is process time? Is this the first time that you all heard about process time?
No.
Okay, so I think some of us, we actually know what's process time. Okay, so process time is a time that we process from sign up until approve or until delivery. I think everyone has to mute your mic. Because, sorry, I have to mute you. Yeah. Okay, so people, if you have questions, then you only unmute yourself. Okay, because it's I'm doing record, so we have to make sure that the one that we are talking right now being recorded, and people that didn't attend, they can actually listen up as well. So if you have any question, you can just unmute yourself and then you can talk. You can voice out your question. Okay, good. Ah, I saw Annie here. Okay, yeah. So is what is process time? So process time is actually from sign up. I mean, we have three part of process time that we need to be measured, and also we would like to achieve it. So the first one is from sign up to apply. So from sign up to apply is actually means that they sign up create account in OP, and then until they actually apply. Sorry people, I think I have to off something so that it doesn't. Okay. Yeah. This thing. Okay, yep. Okay, so means that from sign up in OP, create account in OP until apply. So this one will be mainly under whom entity, which is us, Isaac in Malaysia, we have higher control over that. Okay, so for example, if there's people apply in opportunity portal, and then they will receive our first national newsletter, right? So with this, right, with this we can actually encourage them to apply more projects. So you can see mainly our home entity, they have higher power on that, I mean higher control. Then the second one will be from apply to accept. Okay, from apply opportunity until accept, higher higher power is from hosting entity, because on accept, the hosting entity is the one that to click accept. Okay, so it means that they have higher control over that, and how to make sure that we have a shortened process time is like constantly communicate with our hosting entity. Okay, so the last part is actually from accept to approve. Okay, so from this one, from accept to approve, we have higher control from home entity, which is ourselves, Isaac in Malaysia. We can control it better from accept to approve. For example, one of the initiatives that it actually launched during winter and it continued on this summer peak is the one that the legal form that I actually introduced to everyone. Because with this, our EP doesn't need to pay us like cash, and then we do not need to pass them the physical contract anymore. Everything can be doing through online. So it actually shortened up the process. Means that the applicants, the youth, actually pay to Isaac, for example, Isaac in Penang, through online banking. And then they can just fill up the form through digitally online. Okay, so this is one of the things that we can actually shorten up the process. Okay, so far, anyone have any question? Anyone have any question?
This space is to discuss about how can we fasten the process.
Yeah.
Or just only talk about process time.
You just explain about the process time. So for this part, I will actually brief everyone what is process time. And later on, we can also talk slightly about what is how to fasten up the process time. Okay? Yeah. One thing. Andy, can you be our mini tacker for this space?
Cannot. I'm not right now holding the phone.
Okay. So yeah. Anyone can be our mini tacker. Haywen, can you be our mini tacker?
Okay, can.
Yeah. So you just need to type out the information which is not showing on the slides at the bottom part of the slides.
Okay.
Yeah, so no question, right? It's clear, right? The three stages. And then later on I will show as well the last part, which is the delivery time, which is from approve until realize. Yeah, so that one is slightly hard to be control, because it depends on, for example, if the EP actually get approved on April, and then the realization is already, it's on July, definitely it will be longer. So this one is something that we cannot control. It's the one that we would like to control is from sign up to accept to approve. Cool? Okay, so I will continue if there's no question. Yeah, so right now we know about this is our process time. So look into how are we doing right now? So you can see the current process time is actually, in total, average Malaysia is, we need 9 days to get someone to be accepted. Okay? So accepted, it doesn't mean that you get the project, it's only that you're being accepted by a project for the interview, by hosting entity. Okay? And then we need around 90 days to get someone to be approved. Okay, so you can see this is the progress right now, and you will see some of the entity actually having like zero. Okay, it means that that so far they do not have any accepted yet. They have applicant and do not being accepted yet. Okay, you can see here, this is the process time that we have right now. Okay, so you can see, for example, TU, they need like 11 days, and UPM, they need 12 days in order to get someone being accepted. CU00 because they have no accepted, and this is the days. Yeah, okay. So what does it mean? Why is this important to show everyone? Okay, so for example, imagine that you are the customer right now, putting yourself as a customer. You actually know about this opportunity, like you're able to go out for volunteering and create an impact in that community. Okay, so you actually sign up. Okay, so from sign up until you apply on the project, right? You only wait until like more than 1 week, which is like 9 to 10 days. Only you receive like reply. You being like accepted. So how do you feel? Yeah. So sometimes like people will really like they have very very passion that wanted to go for a project, wanted to go for this volunteering things. However, they will need to wait for like 10 days in order to get. Like to in order to get the first receive, accepted click by the hosting entity. And then they have to wait until like 20 days in order to get approved. Yeah, so for now, I mean, to be honest, right, according to the AI calculation, Malaysia, you actually need longer. I mean, we need around 28 days so far. Yeah, in order to get someone from sign up to approve. So you can see, this is actually very, very long. Like, we need more than 1 month for someone to be actually approved. And this is something that we can actually shorten up so that the people can actually fasten up the process and continue on this thing. Continue to go for exchange. Yeah. So this is the current progress. Yeah. And then what is the thing that as EP manager that we can do? Later on, we'll share about this thing. Okay? So I would like to ask everyone, right, you can actually put your comment here. Yeah. So with this, right, with this data that I show everyone, first one, we see our progress, right, which is a very, very huge gap from what we actually wanted to achieve and what we really achieved. And then after understanding the process time, and you understand that which part that is actually you can do, our home entity can actually focus and have higher power. And then looking right now at our current each entity process time, so I would like to ask the question is, what is your focus right now in your entity for oGV? Yeah. So maybe everyone can have like 1 to 2, 1 minute to think about what is the focus. For example, if you know that my applicants number is actually not achieving what according to what I plan, or my accepted is supposed to be higher, because you see, for example, I take Penang as example. If we are 23 applicants, we would actually like to achieve like higher on accepted. So what is the focus right now you are doing? Yeah. Okay, so I think it's better you can put your entity, for example, Isaac in Penang. Then you can put your goal. Yeah. So what is the focus right now in your entity for oGV? That you can ensure that you actually can achieve your goal. Okay? So I will put a time of 2 minutes for everyone to fill it up. Okay, 2 minutes is up. So, is anyone need more time? Okay, no. Okay, cool. I think I need some. Because when I look through, right, when I look through, right, most of the entity actually putting up like what is you want to be open up. I mean open, increase open rate. Am I right? Okay, so you answer this question as next. Okay, so as OGV, what is your action step to achieve to ensure we achieve the goal, which is the one that we are saying here. Okay, so what is the thing that we can do to achieve the goal? Okay, time's up. Andy, are you done with what you are writing? Because it's only engage more college people, is it? Okay, cool. Andy, are you still here? Okay, so the main reason of this activity, right, if you can see, okay, can everyone hear me now?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay, cool. So actually, if you see here, right, the main objective of this activity is actually to let everyone know, okay, if you see here, right, so what's your focus as OGV, okay, to achieve the goal? You can see that there's a lot, I mean, most of us will say that open rate, to convert sign up to applicants, open, right, open to apply, and all these things. Okay, so when I actually mentioned to you, right, this one, so what is the action step that you can actually take to achieve the goal? Then you can say that constantly engage with potential applicants and everything. I just want to understand a bit, right, from each entity, like, if you have any idea, how do you work with your marketing? How do you work with your marketing department? Is your market, because from what I understand, if you check here, right, this is a status, okay? So for example, when open, someone who actually open, applied, registered in OP, they actually consider open. So it's a very clear cut, or it's a very clear job description to differentiate. Marketing people, is actually they will be responsible, what is the action step, the strategy they are doing, actually get people to sign up and apply the project. Okay, so starting from application, starting from someone being applicant until someone being approved is all fall under EP manager, which is our OGV department. Yeah, so when I actually see here, right, our objective, our focus, mainly, yes, agree to be open up more project. However, when I say here, like, what's the action step? Engage more with the applicants. Remember that this will be, this is good. It's better to be one of the strategy in marketing. So the most important thing that I would like to bring out here is for OGV, we have to make a clear cut on our JD, make sure that we focus on all the applicants. Okay? So for example, how do we actually being using a shorter time to reach out to all the applicants, to engage with them and assign EP manager for them, so that they can actually make sure that they are applied and get accepted and also get approved. Yes. For example, yeah, we can do, I mean, always remember that if you want to put it a clear cut, because I understand some of the entity, right, you are actually, your OGV is actually doing on marketing role. Yeah. So for here, right, I just want to understand from everyone, Is that any entity your OGV is actually focusing on doing marketing, which is not converting them from applicants to accept to approve? Hello? Hello? Okay, so UKM mentioned that in OGV, OGV in UKM is really the one that converts sign up to apply. Okay, so means that your marketing only responsible until sign up? That's what I understand. Okay, cool. How about others entity? Is your OGV responsible until... Okay, in Isaac Utah, OGV journey starting from apply. Yeah. How about other entity? Okay. Because this is something, okay, understand from Isaac UPM that you don't have marketing department. Because understand from the conversation that I had with Annie as well, from Annie, all the EST that she has, right, from any side, they will be making sure that the marketing from in the LC in entity, they will be making sure the number that they want to achieve, the goal is number of applicant. Yes. So starting from applicant to accept to approve, it will fall under OGV responsibility. Yeah. Okay, the main reason I think this is something that I can, I mean, because understanding, there's a few entities, for example, UKM, JB, right? Because if, for example, if your OGV market is that even a UMP as well. If your JD is starting from making sure that the youth from sign up to apply is under OGV, it means that you are doing a lot more to actually making sure that they apply, right? And this is something maybe in your marketing people that can actually, because this is what I agree with Annie as well. For example, marketing, right, they have to make sure that the message, the key message that they are getting is they will put they do marketing, all the marketing, and ensure that all the people that they actually apply in OP, they will click apply on project. And then from OGX, all the EP manager they will starting to approach all the applicants and making sure that they actually being converted from applicants to accept to approve. Okay, in either UNMC, marketing and OGX work together from open to apply. Marcom is the consultant and advisor for marketing strategy and operation for GV. In converting open to apply, marketing and OGV also work together to come up with lead nurturing strategy and also initiative. Marketing mainly acts as the consultant until applied. Yeah. Okay, cool. Understand the situation right now. Because why I'm saying this, why I actually put this upfront to everyone, is because, right, from what I suggested from MC point of view as a consultant for all the entity is, for OGV, right, we need to make sure that, I mean, all your member need to make sure that we convert from applicant to accept to approve. Okay? So from marketing point of view, right, they need to make sure that all the sign up will be converted into applicant. That's why we are doing lead nurturing. We are encouraging them from sign up in OP. When they receive the first email from National Lead Nurturing, it actually encourage them to actually apply project. Yeah. So once they started to apply project, we'll be assigning EP manager to them. Okay? So why? Because when we talk about like a process time, right? When you talk about process time, you can see here. Okay. When you talk about process time, from sign up to apply is fall under home entity. And this one, it can be being structured or being in a way to put these strategies under marketing. When they're doing their lead nurturing, how we can ensure that all people that sign up, or you can add them into a group, or you can do a Facebook lead nurturing or email lead nurturing for making sure that those people signing up, they actually apply for project. After they apply, until accepted is under host entity having higher control. And then with this, right, it's very important for EP manager to actually communicate with the hosting entity. Okay, so later on I will also share how to do that. Okay, so from accept to approve is under home entity, which means that we have to set a communication clear with EP and also the OP tagger, OP manager, to make sure that they will click approve as soon as possible. Yeah, so this will be a strategy, and also the structure that I would like to encourage all the entity to do that. So maybe we can do something like a clear cut expectation for sign up to approve. Okay, so I think one thing that happened here, right? I'm not sure, this is what I'm observing. Some of the entity, right, we will put all our focus on attraction. Okay, so when we have a lot of applicants, then we only convert them. However, if you're sending at a customer point of view, it is not making sense for them. For example, if I'm one of the customer that I actually applied on end of February, okay, like during attraction, and all the entity is actually doing attraction on from February until March, and then if you only finish one pass, then we continue the second pass, which means that maybe I will be being contacted or being reached out by the Isaacer maybe on the end of March, which means that I'm being waited for being contacted. Yeah. So that's why I was encouraging for the entity, you have your own clear cut, making sure that our OGV member actually contacted the applicants once that within 24 hours that they apply. That they apply project.
Yeah.
Okay? So means that for attraction and making sure that people being applied project, it will fall under marketing. This is something that you have to discuss with your marketing, how to do that, the strategy. And then from all the OGV, we have to make sure that we contact all the applicants within 24 hours and making sure that they're being also received reply from hosting entity. Okay. Okay. So, anyone have any question for this part, or you are not sure, or you are confused?
And we need people to keep promoting it, and of course, the topic needs to be relevant. We cannot have people to come here and then they will get something out of it. Yeah.
Is anyone clear on this part, like how to increase the process time? Okay, cool. Pei Wen, you have to take some notes though for the slides. Some notes if there is no, it's not recorded on the slides. Okay? Yeah. So, talking about the process time, right, you can see the next one is I would like to talk about, I'm not sure is everyone clear or not. I will talk about the how actually EXPA work. Okay, just to share with everyone so that we are clear. Because I received like a message from entity, they are not sure about how exactly our applicant's journey on EXPA. Okay, so I was starting with, for example, when there's applicants, one of the youth, the name is Grace, okay? So Grace actually applied. Grace signed up in opportunity OP, and then when Grace, this applicant applied opportunity, so for right now, one applicant maximum you can actually click apply to 15 opportunity at one time. Okay? So after you reach 15, you would not be able to click apply anymore. Unless you have to withdraw some of the opportunity or you being rejected by some of the opportunity, then only you can apply again. Okay, cool. So after that, right, you are being vetted. You have to wait long until the OP manager click accept button. Okay, means that the OP manager, which is another side, the hosting entity, they will click accept. So what does this accept button means? Accept button means that this OP manager actually interested with you and then wanted to have an interview with you. Okay, so the applicants will do the interview with OP manager. Okay, after the interview, if the OP manager think that, okay, I want these applicants, so they will process to accept these applicants, and then how this OP manager will do. So they will send an accepted notes. Okay, so be mindful that accepted notes and is sent by the OP manager. Okay, so for example, if your EP finish the interview, and then being announced that, okay, they will be being accepted for this opportunity, and then they haven't received AN, right? So make sure that as EP manager, you actually approach the OP manager for that. Not with AI. Because this accepted notes is issued by the, is actually sent out by OP manager from that entity. Okay? Then applicant will sign the AN. After that, you have to make sure as EP manager, you have to make sure that the applicant pay for EP fee, sign up the contract, and also complete LDA. Okay, complete the initial LDA. So for example, pay EP fee and also sign up contract. You can do it. You can do it with the OGX legal form right now.
Yeah.
Okay. So lastly, is OP manager and EP manager click approve button. Okay. So this is the last part. one thing, and also the question that I always receive is, for example, if my EP sign up this AN with Isaac, Isaac in Cambodia, okay, this LCA, and then the thing is, if this EP, my EP do not want to go this entity anymore, she want to go to Vietnam, how? Okay, the thing is, signing up AN, it doesn't mean approve. It doesn't mean approve. The most important thing is, at the end, EP manager and OP manager click approve button. Then it's only call, I mean, it's only like officially approved. Okay? So, if, for example, your EP sign up more than one AN, as EP manager, you have to make sure that which opportunity is your EP wanted to go. Okay? Because once you click approve, one, we have the approve stage is done. If your EP do not want to go, the OP manager can ask for compensation. Means that they can ask, hey, you already click approve with me, and then right now, what is the issue why your EP don't want to come? If it's something that is not, is hard to actually, like for example, oh, my EP just want to go to another one, the hosting entity can ask for compensation. They will ask maybe, they can ask you to actually get another EP for them. Okay? So making sure that you click the correct approve button for your EP. Okay? Is it cool for now? Oh, okay. Yeah. Cool. Yeah. So any question for this part? The process on EXPA? No.
Hello?
Yeah. Yes.
Please. Yeah. So I'd like to ask about the acceptance note.
Mm.
Yeah, so it is on the opportunities, right? Like so the acceptance note is just like click accept.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah. Cool. I mean EP do need to click something. I mean it's all digital. Okay?
Mm.
The thing is because remember when you are when you are EB, right, your LCP will send you one thing, like you will accept as a VP. Because membership also, like for us, right, we have to click as well. Like John will send something for me, so I have to click accept. Then I will be matched with the opportunity as MCVP. Okay? So it means that every one of you actually have that experience as well. The thing is, right now, because we have a YOP version 3 soon, it will be launched on the 20th March. Yeah. So right now, from what I understand, it's also the same thing. They will just need to click something. Yeah, it's a very easy and it's an automatic, I mean, it's like a digital thing. Okay, so we will see, is there any updated on it? Okay, like, is there any changes, like how it's a specific instruction for EP? The thing is, it's not complicated one. As long as the hosting entity send something, send a link, it's not an email, okay? Send you a thing, then the EP have to put the name like click, like accept. Then it will be signed.
So it is sent to the EP or sent to me?
EP.
EP, okay. Mm.
So the EP have to always check the account, their own account.
Okay, cool.
Mm. Okay, so for Xiao Jue, okay, sorry. I'm not really know. Okay, yeah, it's not a commitment letter. This is something extra from the hosting entity. It's all on the EXPA. It's all on the platform. Okay? So, for example, what Xiao Jue mentioned, right? The hosting entity said it's a commitment letter. It's something extra that the entity is doing. That one is not considered an AN. Okay? AN is all on EXPA. Cool? What should I do? Maybe you can send me a email later on this thing. Because maybe, I'm not sure, I'm just making assumption. Maybe it's because of, because right now we are actually updating from into YOP version 3, right? So you can see sometimes EXPA is down. Yeah, so maybe this is one of the, it's one of the way for Isaac, LC in Undip, they do to making sure that they actually get this EP into their project. So they actually like offline offline get this EP, like offline accept this EP. Do you get what I mean? Yeah. Because from what I understand, right, everything is on EXPA. Yeah, maybe it's just because of EXPA is down sometime, so they actually created this thing. Yeah. You can send me an email, Seljae, later on, and I will I will check and let you know again. Okay, cool? Yeah, okay, good. So if there's no question for this part, hi Martin, you are here again. Okay, so I will be going on the last part. I will be sharing screen again, which is something also new for everyone to know. So the last part is actually called EP Manager SOP. Okay, so what does SOP mean? SOP actually called Standard Operating Procedure. Okay, so you can click here. You click into the link, then you will see something like this. Wait, it's loading. Okay, so everyone, you can click into this part, or you can actually view on my screen. I will make it bigger. Okay. So this is actually a SOP for EP Manager that I actually created. Okay, so you can see here, they actually, which means that according to what I suggest to all the EP Manager, all the oGV member, this is the processes that it will involve oGV member. That's why it's a very clear cut that I actually mentioned that, for example, attraction part, right, it will be better suggested where for marketing people to making sure that they are they actually attract people until the youth being applicant. Then for us as EP manager, as an oGV member, we'll contact the applicants on EXPA. Okay, is it clear? Okay, so I will go with I will go through one by one with everyone. Okay, so the first one is actually for EP manager. If under my recommend, right, the first thing is actually contact applicants on EXPA. So you can see here, do self introduction, brief about the product, ensure applicants has all the details on OP, because sometimes they actually miss out like academic profile, and sometimes they actually miss out some of the like the details that actually it make them like harder to apply opportunity. Okay, then number four, having a common channel for communication between EP manager and also EP. Okay, number five, ensure that applicant accept national lead nurturing follow-up. Because from what I understand from any is, yes, when they apply when they sign up in OP, they will receive the first email from national lead nurturing. It's actually through get response. The thing is, after like after two or three lead nurturing for national, they need to say accepted. They want to accept to receive more and more email from national lead nurturing, so that the applicant will receive more. Okay, so they have to accept that. And lastly, is they have to make sure that applicant receive local lead nurturing, which is the lead nurturing from your own entity. Okay, so again, reminder is very important to click contact and also interview after you engage with the applicant. Okay, everyone know this part, right? Okay, I will show how. Remember the first one that I mentioned, if you go into OP, EXPA, we click into people, click into my committee EP. Okay, I think it's loading. Register. Yes, I think it's loading lah, EXPA. Okay, so means that after you click into this, right, it will come out, it's supposed to come out a list of names. So after you assign the EP manager, I think, yeah, loading. After you see here, okay? So after you click here, you will see all the member under your entity. This is because I'm logged in with a MC account, that's why I can see the whole exam later. You have to assign EP. You have to assign EP manager. Then after you assign, after you contact with this person, you have to click contact and also interview. Okay, because oGV, we don't do interview anymore, right? Okay.
Yes.
Cool. I just want to confirm on this thing. So after you contacted them, you click a contact and also an interview. Okay? So you see there's a lot of people that actually haven't been contacted. See here, there's all a lot. And then this is, okay, because from when I actually check EXPA, all these things actually make me concerned. Because from my side, I'm not sure, like, I don't know why they didn't being assigned EP manager, and I don't know why they are not being contacted. And with this, I will approach you. And that's why, please, please, and please, for all the LC VPs or the director that are here today, making sure that you deliver this to your department. Okay? Making sure that we assign EP manager and also click all these things. Okay? So if you can see back, look back here, right? We assign, we will contact the applicants on EXPA suggestibility, like within 24 hours. Okay? So you put yourself in customer shoes. Imagine that you actually inquire something new. Like, for example, your phone, you want to have, like, you actually purchase something. Okay, you want to inquire something, and then you send a request. Definitely, you wish to receive reply within 24 hours, right? So you just put yourself as a customer. How long that you're willing to actually wait? If someone that actually reply you 24 hours, do you feel like actually very happy, and then you feel like very excited to continue? Okay, the second one, we actually follow up with as an EP manager. We actually after contacted them, we actually follow up and also send reminder about the opportunity, about lead nurturing and everything. Okay, so there's like 48 hours until 7 days. Definitely, I would like to put it like shorter lah, like not 7 days. Okay, so making sure that after they apply, they actually get reply from posting entity. Okay, definitely from here you can actually introduce them your LCLC partnership or any partnership that Isaac Malaysia is building MCMC side. Cool? Okay, so after that, if they actually get accepted, they will move under consideration phase. So on here, right, making sure that you notify and you ask the hosting entity to actually give the result announcement within 24 hours until 48 hours after the interview. Okay, so one thing that you can actually can make it easier is as an EP manager, making sure that you remind or you share with your EP that, okay, after your interview, remember that to set to ask for result. Okay, like after the interview, that, or remember that after your interview, you have to ask result within like 48 hours with the hosting entity. Do not, I mean, because sometimes if just a small reminder, hosting entity, they will actually okay send you the result as soon as possible. Okay, then the second one, after they're actually being accepted or like after the interview, if the hosting entity wanted your EP, they will actually send you the accepted notes. Okay, it's also within 24 hours as soon as possible. So you can see here, right, there's a lot of commitment needed, like constantly communication as an EP manager with the EP and also hosting entity. Okay, that's why I was saying that all this part is supposed to fall under EP manager, which is under OGV member. So for the attraction part, I would suggest communicate well with the marketing. Let them to handle. Okay? Yeah. So it's a very clear cut that we actually separate. For OGV, we are making sure that we are doing our best for EP, for our customer experience. Cool? Okay. Then after that, after they actually sign accepted note, sign EP agreement, making payment, and also ensure that the applicant complete LDA within 24 hours. Because everything right now in Isaac Malaysia, everything is by digital. We have the form. So all these things is actually very easy to get it done. Previously, what I know is, for example, when I'm still a director, I have to meet my EP physically. Then she passed me like the 600. And then I would pass her the contract. Right now, no longer we need to do that because we have a digital form. And I hope that everyone has the digital form and it's worked perfectly, okay? Yeah, I hope that because I didn't receive any like reply. I mean, I didn't receive any entity saying that it's not working, okay? So making sure that it is really working. So lastly is home entity and also hosting entity to click approve together on EXPA within 24 hours. Okay, all these things can be actually done very quickly as long as there's a clear system and also communication between EP manager, EP, and also the OP manager, the hosting entity. Clear? So far, is it okay? Good.
Hello?
Yes.
Yes. I want to ask about the in the EXPA, right?
Mm.
After we contact the EP, then we need to click on the contacted and interview.
Mm.
I thought the interview is after the EP was interviewed by the OPM.
No, I mean they are not really because that one is a button that it clicked by EP manager.
They cannot
click what? Yeah. I mean this is okay, all okay. Like as an EP manager you can click for them.
Okay, cool.
Cool? Okay. So thank you UKM, the legal form worked perfectly. Okay. Yeah. One reminder, for the legal form, right, you don't move anything. And then because later on, like I think this week Paula will actually introduce everyone like the cooperative email and everything, right? And it stated there very clearly that do not move the legal form, the whole document. Yeah, because if you move, it will destroy the coding. Yeah, then it will not work perfectly anymore. Okay, so a reminder again with all the member here, you do not move the folder. Okay, cool. If everyone is clear until this stage, we will move into the standards, which is slightly you have to pay attention because there's changes according to the previous 16 SNS. Cool. Okay, we'll move on to standards. Okay, so if you can see standard here, just an update. After we click approve, it officially the EP will go in. I mean, they officially is our customer. Okay, we call EP. And then in here you can see all the standard will be delivered. And one thing is because previously we call it 16 SNS, which is 16 standard and satisfaction. Right now, after IPM on February, we actually change it into 16 standards. And then the another satisfaction is for under NPS. Okay, cool. So right now you can see I actually put all the standard here already. And then I actually arrange it according to the time period. Okay, so later on I will explain it one by one. So for example, I put as well home entity which is Isaac Malaysia, hosting entity which is means that another entity that the EP is going. So the first one, ensure EP has a visa and also insurance. Suggestible is 3 weeks before realized. Okay, ensure EP receive arrival pickup information, which is 3 weeks before realized. So one thing is very important is sometimes we confuse about arrival pickup and also airport pickup. So in the standard, it doesn't mean that you need to pick up the EP at airport. It only means that you have to pick up the EP on the day that they arrive. Okay, so actually you need to confirm it very very well with a hosting entity. If they are not picking up the EP on airport, where do they pick up the EP? Okay, yeah. So next is ensure the hosting entity actually send out the basic information about the country. You can have the more details later on. I will share with everyone. You can see there, okay, which is 3 weeks before realized. Suggestible. This is the one that I'm saying. Okay, so number four, you can see this is under home and under home, right? So making sure that we have goal setting based on LDA result, which is the initial LDA, which is this LDA, okay, the LDA here. And then from this LDA result, we actually set a goal with them. And then ensure that we have outgoing preparation happens. Okay, then after that, EP go for exchange. So we have to ensure that as an EP manager, our EP receive incoming preparation. It's once EP realized and before the internship start. This is stated in the standards, okay? So we have to make sure that the accommodation and condition actually correspond with the information on opportunity. You can see here, this is something that is suggestible, which is on the first week of realize and also follow up on the third week. Why we need to follow up? Because I understand that sometimes, right, our EP throughout the 6 weeks, they are not always staying at the same place. Sometimes they are actually moving here and there, right? So making sure that the condition is actually, you do a follow-up with them again. So is this something that they actually put into the opportunity and saying that, okay, for example, the first 2 weeks we'll do it and in, for example, in Phnom Penh of Cambodia, Then the last 4 weeks, we'll do it at same rate of Cambodia and the condition and everything. So making sure that as EP manager, we follow up on this part. Okay, then we ensure that there's representative of Isaac actually assist EP to workplace, which is on the first day of realized. Okay, so it's very important, very important that we have to make sure that a hosting entity actually click realize within 24 hours when the EP arrived and started the project. Okay, continue. We have also JD correspond with the opportunity. We can see here in the time period. And also JD, the job is going to align with your personal goal. Okay, this personal goal is a goal that we actually having here just now, the goal setting. Okay, it's here with home entity. So the host entity, they have to do alignment on JD and also personal goal. Okay, next, ensure internship is actually minimum 25 hours per week. Okay, you have to do follow up as EP manager. And at the same time, you have to make sure that the internship is minimum with 6 weeks. Okay, so and then next, if like for example, if the project is saying that, okay, we will provide you lunch and also free accommodation, making sure all these things actually correspond with the opportunity. For example, if the EP saying that initially they say, oh, during the opportunity, or oh, it will be provided free for accommodation. However, when your EP arrived there, it's not free, then as EP manager, you have to support EP on this part. Okay? So next is lead spaces. Making sure that we actually communicate with our EP and facilitate their experience every week on that 6 week. Okay? So we have also one thing is debrief the job description with a personal goal. This is something that, sorry, I forgot to put, is under host. Which is 1 week before the EP complete, the hosting entity have to do debrief. Okay? And then they have to making sure that the EP receive departure support before they actually leave, before actually complete. Cool? So this is all the standards in the updated standards from after IPM. IPM is called International President Meet. Okay, so the last standard is over here, which is on brand advocacy, which is as a home entity, we have to debrief for the return EP within 2 weeks after the EP arrived Malaysia. So we can also call them like a reintegration activity for the EP. Okay, so this is all the standard here. And if you want to know more, you can actually click here. You can see here, 16 standard updated after IPM 2017. Okay, so if you can see here, so you can see here, it's no longer called 16 standards because right now we call it 16, because previously we call it SNS, 16 SNS, right? Right now it's all, this is all standards, and this, and the satisfaction will measure on NPS. Okay, and then if you can see, it actually slightly changing. Okay, because previously, right, if you notice, the development, the yellow part is on the last 4. Right now, we put it at the first 6. Because if Isaac mentioned about leadership and why we are putting all the development at the last 4, that's why right now it moved into the first 6. So you can see all here, this is the standard that we are actually mentioning. However, in the SOP, I didn't put accordingly to 1 to 16. I put it accordingly to the time period so that for EP manager, it's easier for you to actually go, you know, right, how to actually, the flow of the EP experience. Okay? So you can actually view all these things. You can read all these things as well. And then it's very important as well. We actually have a question to ask them. And then how the EP, we actually answer is just yes and no. Okay? So you can read everything here. This is the version that we have during IPM. I believe that there will be a better version because slightly when you read, right, it will be a bit confused. It will be slightly confused on the part behind. Yeah. So, so for example here, right, it will be slightly, they actually show how is the changes on all this part. Okay, so if you would like to know more, you can actually read all these things. Yeah, if you have any question, you can ask me. Cool? Yeah. So this is just for your information. And then for this part, it's a standard that I will everyone can have a look. And also, it will be good that we can follow all the SOP with the time period. Okay, so far, I'm done with all this part. Is there any question that you would like to ask me? Hello?
Oh.
No. Okay, no. Anyone have any question?
Hello, Grace.
Yes, yes.
I have a question, but it's not for the right of advocacy part, it's for the EXPA thing.
Oh, okay, okay, okay. Later, maybe we have an open space for other questions. Yeah. So,
okay, sure.
About okay. The SOP that I actually present, is there anyone have any question? Okay. I will assume there's no question, yeah? Okay. If there's no question, okay, then we'll move into a space we call it, okay. So if there's no question, we'll go into the part that we call open spaces. So you can actually ask question here. Or you can actually share any good catch practice here as well. Okay, so Pei Wen, just now you mentioned that you have actually a question about EXPA, right? May I know what's the question?
Like for the contactor and interview. Because after we engage with the people who sign out, we actually click the contactor, but we haven't clicked the interview because like the interview thing for us is like expectation setting. Like after we have an expectation setting to let them know and also to ensure to let them know about like what we can provide and also to make sure that they have the right mindset. Only that expectation setting only we click interview on EXPA and the expectation setting would be done before approved. So is that okay?
Yeah, okay.
Okay.
It's okay. Yeah. It's just making sure that we do not do any interview. I mean like anything can do expectation setting. You just need to make ensure that we don't do interview to fail any EP. Yeah. Because now, yeah, everyone actually can go for, because previously in very, very old era, right, we are actually fail EP through the interview. Yeah. So right now we are not doing that because everyone can go for exchange. Yeah. It just, you can do expectation setting with them. Okay, cool.
Okay,
yes,
cool.
Understand.
Thank you.
Welcome. Okay, so anyone have any question to ask on this open space? No? No one have question? I am. Okay, maybe I will give like 5 seconds to wait for anyone to think about the question if you have any question. Yeah, if you have any question about marketing, you can ask as well because I am the ESC is here. Yeah. So in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. No question? Okay. Yes, hello, hi.
So I'm Jenny. So I actually have a question. Like I want to ask, because everyone is LBP here, right? So I actually want to ask which LC is actually like the oGV team is focusing for marketing. Means there will be no oGV team and marketing team separate. Can I know which LC are in this situation?
Because in either UPM, right, we do not have a marketing department, right?
Yes.
Yeah, so that's why they have to do like also attraction and also converting. Yeah. So is there any entities is having this structure as well? Actually from my understanding there's no. I think it's only UPM. From my understanding.
Okay.
Yeah. So I think a suggestion from your side, because also I understand that you have only 5 members, right?
Around six.
Yeah. So one thing is you have to make sure that you have enough capacity to do this thing. If you don't have enough capacity, maybe you have to recruit, or you can open up like task force, like only focusing on attraction, and then you have to also separate some people to do converting, because UPM actually you have very, very high applicants, and then you do not have you do not convert them, you do not contact them, so that maybe this is one of the cause that they didn't being accepted. Yeah, this is one of the assumption that I have, maybe this is one of the reasons. Yeah, because UPM, you are the one of the highest on applicants, and then the acceptance is actually dropped. Yeah, okay? So making sure that you actually have enough people to do converting as well. Okay? Cool. I think I actually asked about like Isaac Sunway, how they can actually achieve higher on applicants. So what they actually told me, what Jia Yue told me, let me check. What Jia Yue told me is they're actually using their return EP to do sharing. Okay, let me check if no mistake. To do sharing, and also because most of the sharing is actually very interesting. Yeah, so that's why it actually attract a lot of people to be applicants. And then Javier told me that as well, all their OGV members, they actually engage with all the applicants very, very quick. Yeah. Yeah. At the same time, because we have also lead nurturing, right? You can do opportunity marketing. Like, you can tell them, oh, this is the opportunity that we have right now. Of course, you are not forcing them to apply the opportunity. You are introducing that this is the opportunity that we have right now. Okay? Yeah. This is a sharing, good case sharing from GCP from Isaac Sunway. How do they actually get applicants, and how do they able to convert them to accepted as soon as possible? Any question? So I will also count in 5 seconds. If there's no question, then we will move on. In 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay, good. Okay, so definitely, I mean, when I say question, it's not necessarily like question about the session. If you have any question about like converting, or you have question about what's the role, any question. Okay, so today, right, I just need to wrap up a bit. We actually talk about what is the current process, I mean the progress of all the entity here. If you can see, we are very, very far behind on the according to what we want to achieve. Yeah, so with this, right, what's the strategy that your entity can actually come out? Yeah, and then I actually suggested everyone to have a very, very clear cut role on marketing role and also your OGV role. Okay, so I would like to say that do not have the idea that, oh, we let's attract 200 people, then only we at one time convert them. Because if you put yourself as customer point of view, you would not like to being waited for like 1 or 2 weeks, then only being contacted and only being like explain how to go the process. Okay? Definitely you want to receive response as soon as possible, right? So how should I say this in English? Like, if you don't want to receive this, and also at the same time you don't provide these services to others as well. Okay? Then move on, we actually talk about process time. Then you actually see that in which stages it actually fall under. I mean, as a home entity, as a sending entity, you have higher control over that. From sign up to apply and from accepted to approve. Okay? So with this, you know that, okay, for example, if I want my EP being accepted faster, how do I do that? Approach your hosting entity. Okay? Yeah. So with this as well, we move on into our EP manager role. And also the SOP, then you can see what's the role, what's the thing that I have to do, how do I ensure my EP receive all the standards. Okay? Yeah. So all these things is about today, education and also sharing. Oh, the last one I forgot is about how is my EP applicants flow during on EXPA. Yeah, like for example, who assigned AN, who click accepted, if I want to click approve, how do I click approve, how do I assign EP manager? Yeah. So all these things is about during EXPA. Yeah, okay. So if there's no question, I would like to actually ask everyone for a flavor, which is you can click into the next slide. Yeah. Can everyone click into the feedback survey form? Yeah. So please click here to provide a feedback, and you can rate on how do you think about today's session. Okay? So I will put like 2 minutes for everyone to fill in. I will put I'll put 2 minutes. At the same time, I can play a song. for everyone. This one, okay lah. Okay, so everyone please click into the survey form and fill it up, okay? Yeah, so that we can actually improve on the next session. For example, you prefer what kind of environment, or do you think the session is actually good? Is it provide you information for you to do your operation? Okay? Stranger, I can't believe that she's mine. Now all I see is you with fresh eyes, fresh eyes. So suddenly I'm in love with a stranger. Please click here for the survey form. She's mine. Yeah. And now all I see is you with fresh eyes, fresh eyes. Appreciation. Well, it comes and it goes, but I ride that way with you. It's human nature. Don't mess with under your nose till you remind the fool. Maybe all of this is simple. My heart's unconditional. You dress up just a little and I'm like, so suddenly I'm in love with a stranger. I can't believe that she's mine. Now all I see is you with fresh eyes, fresh eyes. So suddenly I'm in love with a stranger. I can't believe that she's mine. And now all I see is you with fresh eyes. Okay, is everyone done with the survey form? Love this song, okay. Is everyone done? Do you need more time? Yeah, Xiaojuan, you can put oGV education 1, something like that, yeah. Okay, 5 more minutes. Okay, I will continue play the song until it ends, okay? Okay, thank you so much for coming to the meeting. Okay, wait, we haven't finished. Okay, so thank you for filling up the form for us so that I know where to improve. I will check it later on. And thanks for all the feedback. Okay, so I think last thing, right? Maybe. Yeah, so actually, what I actually wrote here is like what went well or even better if for the session. Yeah. So, do you know what went well and even better if, for example, what went well of the session? Or maybe you can say, I think what went well is Grace play a music during the space, then we can actually enjoy the music and also fill in out the form. This is one of the examples. Okay, Kalais is looking at me. Okay. So, okay, maybe even better if is, for example, maybe even better if we can have a better connection, or maybe even better if we can more have more good cash practice sharing. Yeah, okay. So maybe we can, you, anyone have any comment that you can actually would like to put it down here? Yeah, anyone have any what went well and even better if that you would like to put it down here? No? Okay, maybe I can put for mine first. Paiwen, can you help us to jot down? Okay, thank you, Shinny.
Yeah, sure.
Okay, I think what one of the what went well is, I'm not sure, like, Ayam are actually, is actually here. So I think it would be good that, like, Ayam, okay, Ayam, everyone know, right? Ayam, he's actually the EST for Annie on B2C. Yeah, so I think what went well is actually he can be here. So maybe sometimes, if anyone have any question in coming future, and we have, like, EST here, you can ask them question. Yeah. Thank you, Ayam, for joining us today. Mm. And then I think maybe even better if is we can have people respond towards the session. I mean, throughout the sessions. Yeah. For example, if anyone have no question, then we will just say, oh, no question. Yeah. Or if you have question, you can say, oh, I have question and I would like to ask. Yeah. Just be more open up and also be responsive towards the question. Yeah. Cool. So, anyone have any other question? Oh, sorry. Comment on what went well and even better if?
Hello.
Okay, thank you, Vienna.
Okay, so what went well for me is the new information that I gather from you, which is the 16 standards.
Okay.
Uh-huh. And also the EPM SOP.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Mm, okay, thank you.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, I have what even better if. Yeah, even better if that we can actually have more people to join us. Yeah, so more LC can join. Okay, so any other even better if or what went well from anyone? Okay, I will count until 5 seconds. If there's no, I will just close the space. Okay? So in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay, we'll close what went well and even better if space. Okay, so... Oh, okay. Oh, why you all wrote right here? Okay, I don't know. Okay, yeah. Okay, so... EST is here, very concrete education and information, content is well organized and love the song. Okay, more responsive from everyone for the session, be more open up and responsive. Clearer role clarification between OGV and marketing, will bring this up during EP, BP marketing meet. Everyone from LC can share the slide earlier. Okay, cool. I just want to ask, right, I'm not sure, like, clearer role clarification between OGV and marketing, would you like to explain slightly a bit more on this part? Because I'm not very sure, and I do not like to have like assumption. Ayam, is it you are the one that writing this down?
Hello.
Yeah, it's clear.
No, I think I'm kind of confused whether like within local, in local entities, OGV is doing what and marketing is doing what, so. We'll bring this up during BP marketing, no, where like to ask and see that like what is their focus on March.
Oh, okay.
I think, never mind, I don't know.
Okay. I think because this is something that actually I discussed with Annie like quite some time ago, very long time ago, like marketing, we'll making sure that actually marketing will get people to apply. Project, so it's like the MOIs, the measurement for marketing is applicants, and then from starting from OGV, it will be accept and approve, and then also the value delivery part. Yeah, so I think it would be good that I can also communicate with any again and making sure that this is clear for the entity.
Yeah,
okay?
Yeah.
Yeah, cool. So if there's nothing much, we'll just close the space. Okay? So just like to ensure that really no question, right? It's good to go, right? Okay, so if like that, let's close the space in 1, 2, 3. Okay, yeah. Thank you for everyone to be attend today. So if you can read all the information that is being mentioned, and then if you have any question, just drop me email or can WhatsApp me. Okay, thank you everyone for joining. Bye bye. Bye. Okay. Bye bye. Bye bye. Bye. Bye bye. Bye bye. Bye bye. Bye bye. Thank you. Welcome. See you. Da 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 da. Can you open the song again?